Sita from class 8B stand before you to illuminate all about life of Kamala Das, the unsung hero who played a pivoted role in Indian freedom struggle. Kamala Das Gupta was a militant freedom fighter. She was born to a respectable Vaidya family of Vikrampur in Dhaka. The family later moved to Kolkata, where Kamala did her MA in history. Up to her joining the university, Kamala was a model student and daughter. But there a burning desire to be of use to the nation gripped her. She even tried to quit her studies and entered Gandhi's Sabarmati Ashram. But her parents disapproved. Finishing her education, she befriended some members of Jugantar Party and was quickly converted from her original Gandhism to the cult of armed resistance. In 1930, she left home and became manager of a hostel for poor women. There she stored bombs and bomb-making materials for the revolutionaries. She was arrested several times in connection with bombings, but she always released for a want of evidence. She supplied Binada's QV with the revolver that she used to try to shoot Governor Jackson in 1932 and was arrested also on that occasion but released. In 1933, the British finally succeeded in putting her behind bars. There she stayed till 1936 and subsequently was placed under house arrest. In 1938, the Jugantar Party was aligned itself with Indian National Congress and Kamala also transferred her allegiance towards the larger party. Thenceforth, she became involved in relief work, especially with the Bhoomi refugees of 1942 and 43. And within 1946 to 47, with the victims of communal rioting. She was in charge of relief work at Noakhali that Gandhiji visited in 1946. She also worked for women's vocational training at the Congress Mahila Shilpa Kendra and Dakshineshwar Nari Swabhalambi Sadhan. She edited women's journal Mandira for many years. She authored two memoirs in Bengali Raktar Akshare, The Letter of Blood in 1954 and Swadhi Neta Sangrami Nari, Women's Freedom Struggle in 1963. Here I conclude my speech, Vande Mataram.